Now the telescope is brought in line with the collimator, and through the prism a direct ray will be observed and found in the eyepiece that should be focused by using your eye. If it is not clearly visible, you have to remove the prism and then keep it down. Now the image will be clearly seen. Now any fine adjustments to get a sharp image can be done using this screw, the side screw. And now the telescope is fixed in this position, and using the fine adjustment screw, the image of the slit that is visible inside will be now brought in coincidence with the vertical crosswalk. This is the final position, as you can see now. It's a direct image of the slit, now in coincidence with the vertical crosswalk. So this is position R4. Once again the reading is taken in the vernier 1 as before, the same process, and then in the case of vernier 2 here. Now to find out the angle of minimum deviation, which is capital D, is nothing but equal to R3 difference R4. Once again you will get two readings, one for the vernier 1 and one for the vernier 2. You have to find both using the same formula and find out the average of the two. That will be taken as the actual value of angle of deviation, minimum deviation. Now using the formula, refractive index mu is equal to sine of a plus d by 2 divided by sine of a by 2. You can find out the refractive index of the glass with which the prism is being made. So we are going to find out the refractive index of this glass, that's by using this formula. So that's how the refractive index is formed.